AC Milan 1, Liverpool 2. 6-6. The whole English side to do that in the group stage of the Champions League. Super, super proud. Before we get started, please do click on that like button. It helps us reach more people. The algorithm works that way, but let's get into it. Just so proud of this team. Just so proud of what these group of players and Jurgen Klopp has built. What we're achieving is absolutely remarkable. We made so many changes for this game. Mane, Salah, Alisson did start, but we made so many changes. And the way we played, it's in our DNA now to press. It's in our DNA to keep the ball. It's in our DNA to dominate the game. We did that against the Milan side, which is in top of Serie A. We did that against the Milan side at San Siro. We did that against the Milan side who had so much to play for. And yet, we did that. Absolutely remarkable. Neco Williams, Tsimikas, solid. Neco Williams now is becoming into someone who probably now we can rely on if Trent wants to rest a game or two. Tsimikas has already done that. Alisson, a few vital saves. My man of the match pick was Konate. Beast. The way he handled Milan defensively. And speaking of beast, Nat Phillips, the Bolton Baresi, that turn in the middle of the box in such a crucial time when we were leading just 2-1. Amazing. It's such a shame that it might be the last game in the UEFA Champions League that Nat Phillips plays in the colours of Liverpool. But it is what it is. He's one of the reasons why we are here. So kind of emotional on that front, but it won't be the last game in the Liverpool colours in the Champions League for Tyler Morton. The youngster is a revelation. He's fabulous, just so calm under pressure. Another 90 odd minutes for him, and boy oh boy, is going to become such a great player. Speaking of good players, speaking of showing brilliance, Oxlade Chamberlain. Last 3 or 4 occasions he started, he has been remarkable. Again yesterday, he's a ball carrier. He just provides something very different compared to all our midfielders, and he will start more games. I will just say that. And I'm delighted with the way he's playing, and touchwood, not getting injured. Minamino started in the midfield on the left-hand side. He was kind of responsible for the first goal that we conceded, but the way he reacted, the way he kept his cool, the way he was passing around, the way he dealt with everything physically to play against Tonali and Frank Essie is not easy. He did that very well. So I'm happy. In an unnatural position, Minamino did really well. Mane had a Sadio Mane game, brilliant. Can't say more about that. A Sadio Mane game means that he hustled. He made the opposition work really hard. He was involved in the second goal, which Origi scored. Speaking of Mo Salah, his contract claim, whatever conditions he wants, it's tough to argue with everything that's happening right now. 20 and counting. I remember at the halfway mark we're talking about it. This season, he's averaging a goal and assist every 62 minutes. Baffles my mind. It's remarkable. Mo Salah. And yesterday, you could see him. He was just so happy. He was smiling. He wanted to play. Jurgen Klopp mentioned that Mane, Salah, Alisson said that they wanted to play. And speaking of playing, football is nothing without Origi, right? Origi. Scored the winner once again. Whether it's Molyneux or Milan, it doesn't matter. Divock Origi always delivers. Right place at the right time. Just not the goal throughout the game. His ball control, his turns, his physicality, his hold-up play was really good. Divock Origi, I think his contract runs at the end of the year, and I'm sure there'll be a few people within the camp will be like, do you want to sign a year's extension? Because if you're happy just coming off the bench, it's not a bad option by any stretch of the imagination. He is a cult hero for us. But the draw is on Monday now, and we have topped the group. The group of death, brushed aside by Liverpool. 6-6. The red men in Europe, European royalty. Jurgen Klopp and his boys are working their magic. It'll be interesting to see who we meet in the round of 16 for the round of 16 draw. I'm sure we'll come up with something. Until then, take care and bring on Stevie G and Aston Villa.